went down to the River Jordan, where John baptized three, where I walked the devil in hell.
Throughout the 1800s, Richmond became a dominant hub for slave activity in the United States. The city held more auctions, shipped out more humans, and held more slaves in jails than any other city in the United States. One question still remains. What made the Richmond area fit for such an extensive slave trade? I set out to make a conclusion. The Atlantic slave trade was the driving force of slavery in the United States. Ships left Great Britain and sailed towards Western Africa. Upon reaching Africa, traders would round up Africans and force them onto their ships. The traders and slaves then sailed towards North America. The slaves' time in Richmond was grueling. After the lengthy journey from other ports along the East Coast, slave ships would sail up the James River to Richmond. Once they reached the city, they would dock at Rocket's Landing. They would be unloaded in the dead of night so that Richmonders wouldn't notice the awful condition the slaves were in after their long journey. The slaves would then be forced to walk on a forest trail to their next stop, holding facilities. Slave holding facilities were where the slaves would wait to be prepared for auction. The most famous of these facilities was Lumpkin's Jail. Often referred to as the Devil's Half Acre, Lumpkin's Jail was a place of extreme hardship for thousands of slaves. Robert Lumpkin, the fierce owner of the jail, is said to have tortured most of the slaves that came through his facility. To add to the torture, conditions in the jails were awful. In recent years, archaeologists have unearthed the remains of Lumpkin's Jail. Today, a building similar to the one seen at the jail and of the same time period stands at the jail's original location. Adjacent to the building is a field that is said to be the burial ground for thousands of Richmond slaves. The next stop on the journey was the auction. The vast majority of auctions in Richmond were held in an area called Wall Street. Wall Street ran right through the center of the city. It was lined on either side by countless auction houses and hotels for slave buyers and traders. When an auction was coming up, the auction houses would raise some sort of flag in front of their building to inform buyers of the upcoming event. On the day of the auction, a group of slaves would be taken from their holding facilities and dressed up to look more appealing for the auction. They would then be taken to a select auction house where they would stand on a platform in front of a group of buyers. After being sold, the slaves would immediately be taken with their buyer. This time marked the last time many slaves' families would ever see each other. At the time, the slave trade was by far the city's largest industry. Going back in time to the earliest traces of slavery in Virginia, it became evident to me that tobacco brought the first slaves to the state. Plantation owners looked to slavery to make profit in farming the abundant crop. The tobacco industry flourished in Virginia and its neighboring states and ended up being a key factor that led to the construction of many towns like Richmond. Early slave traders chose Richmond as a hub likely because of its geographic location. It was situated midway between the major cities of the Northeast and the cotton-heavy South. Just west of Richmond was prime territory for tobacco and other highly demanded crops. The James River made the city accessible by boat, and canals and roadways made travel within the city feasible. Like many other cities of the time period, Richmond was looking for an industry that could grow the city. When slave traders first arrived, Richmonders saw the opportunity to expand. In 1807, when the United States banned all importation of slaves from Africa, cities like Richmond benefited in many different ways. Buyers were now forced to travel to Richmond to inspect and purchase slaves. In the end, the importation ban had no true negative effects on the city. Instead, it brought in more money and increased the population drastically. When the retreating Confederates burned the city of Richmond in 1865, most of the physical signs of the slave trade were finally gone for good. In the years since, countless memorials have been erected to pay tribute to the astounding hardship that so many slaves faced. One of the most prominent of these memorials is the Reconciliation Statue in Chaco Bottom. It shows three human beings, each signifying a corner of the slave triangle, embracing in a union of freedom. I urge each and every one of you to consider walking the historic Richmond Slave Trail the next time you are in the city. It is an eye-opening experience, and it will surely give you a new perspective on the magnitude of slave life in Richmond.
You know the captain told the pilot, fool, that Katie was me.
Well, Katie was me.
He cried, bitch, but in Greenville gone, gone be her tree.
Gone be her tree.
He cried, bitch, but in Greenville gone, gone be her tree.
Gone be her tree.
You know Arkansas City gone.